Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone. My name is Jorge Colmenar, and I'm going to show you the result obtained working with my Portuguese colleagues in an Upper Ordovician section of the Busaco area in Portugal. During the Upper Ordovician, Portugal was located in high latitudes of Gondwana and belonged to the Mediterranean faunistic province. This province, by the beginning of the late Ordovician, was characterized by low diversity endemic communities which inhabited the shallow silicyclastic shelves of Gondwana. These communities were dominated mainly by Etherortis, as for example the Svobodina Havlicheki community, and also by Drabovids, as occur in sometimes in Portugal and Bohemia. And here you can just have an example of these Drabovid dominated communities for the lower Katian of Portugal. A little bit after, during the mid to late Katian, a global warming event, so called Boda event, occurred that allowed the precipitation of carbonates in high latitude and mid latitude platforms. Taking advantage of these new niches created, several taxa from low latitude platforms invade these carbonate platforms, wiping out most of the endemic taxa living there. And as a consequence, the endemism in the region decreases and the diversity in the communities rise. Well, among these invaders stand out the member of the Nicolera community, that is a brachiopod-dominated community, really highly diverse, reaching up to 28 species in a single locality. And it's dominated mainly by the brachiopod Nicolella actonia in the upper left part, but also for the typical brachiopods of this community, Anastrophia, Porambonites, etc. After this paleobiographical and paleoecological introduction, I'm going to show you where is located the section we studied. It belongs to the Portuguese Central Iberian Zone, concretely the Busaco syncline. Here you can observe the newest geological map of the region performed by Neri Delgado at the beginning of the 19th century and compiled after by Carrington da Costa in the 1950. Concretely, the rocks of the studied locality belong to the Porto de Santana formation that is represented here in this map in a pink dotted color. The locality we studied, the Cabeça Pedrógão locality, is one of the most typical localities discovered by Delgado more than 100 years ago. Well, the Porto Santana formation is mid to late Cadian in age, and it's composed mainly by volcanic rocks that are usually weathered in a typical orange color. Here you can observe one of these volcanic rocks. In the lower part of the image, you can observe the real color of the volcanic rocks, the typical blue color, and in the upper part, the beginning of the alteration of this rock. Also, it's commonly to find some samples with vacuolar porosity, as this sample here. But the most important thing is this formation is really fossiliferous, mainly in the lower and middle parts. Here you can observe two of these examples that is completely full of bryozoans, brachiopods, and also trilobites. At the top of the formation is sometimes present some silicified levels that are also really fossiliferous and that were probably formerly limestones that are the goal of this work. And laterally, these rocks pass into limestones and dolostone of the Ferradosa formation. And here you can observe the stratotype of this formation that is placed in an abandoned quarry close to the Ferradosa village. Well, working the Busaco area is not easy due to vegetation. Here you can observe one of our colleagues looking for an outcrop completely surrounded by brambles. This sometimes leads into desperation among us. This is justified because the recent condition of the main sections. Here you can observe, or maybe not because it's completely covered of vegetation, the upper part of the stratotype of the upper part of the Porto Santana formation, and approximately where is seated my colleague Sofia, is placed, believe me, the boundary with the Silurian rocks. Well, this required us some extra work with sophisticated tools to clean the localities, and also caused the destruction of some forest paths. Well, in this case, we were lucky and we found a really good outcrop in the Cabeça Pedrógão Hill that in which we can observe the silicified levels of the uppermost part of the Porto de Santana formation. In this locality, it's fairly common to find some silicified fossils, like these echinoderms, algae, and bryozoans, but the most common way of preservation in this locality is to find the fossils in internal and external molds. Well, after a hard work, splitting this extremely hard work by most of the colleagues, while others were just taking selfies, we obtained a really fairly diverse association composed by more than 13 brachiopod species, being the most abundant Nicolella toni that I told you before is the more typical taxa of the Nicolella community, and also appear here also other taxa really typical of this community. Also, we found six trilobite species. Sorry. And you can observe the material is very fragmentary, but allowed to some interesting identification and also some interesting implications, as I want to show you later. Also, we found more than 9 echinoderm taxa, being the most common echinospherites, but also a really fairly common and diverse the crinoid and column and cystoid columnal plates. And finally, we found few but fairly diverse algae and bryozoans. Many of the brachiopods and the echinoderms found here are represented in most of the upper Ordovician formations in the Mediterranean province after the Boda event. But for example, the trilobites are almost exclusively represented in only one formation, the cystoid limestone formation from the Iberian chains, excepting Ilenus crever that is also present in the Portichedo formation from Sardinia. It's also remarkable that the presence here of Ceraurinus and Bumastus represent the first occurrence of this taxa in Portugal. Other species also present in the Portichedo formation is Chierina pedronensis that occur together with Eparamonites dreyfusi in the Gabian formation of the Montagne Noire. Also, we found other two taxa that were previously known only in other formations, the Ram formation for the American Massif, that are Chierina, the brachiopods Chierina melui and Vicus pinna americana. Well, some of these fossils we found allow to dating more precisely the age of the sample levels. For example, the presence here of Eparamonites dreyfusi, previously known only in the upper part of the Gabion formation, indicate for these levels an age probably younger than the levels containing the other species of Porambonites, Porambonites magnus, that occur also in the lower part of these two formations. The same occurred with the presence here of Chierina melui that were previously known only in the upper part of the Rosan formation. These species occur always above the levels containing Chierina madanensis. Finally, the presence here of Bumastus commodus, that, as I told you before, is also present in the cystoid limestone of the Iberian chains, but also occurs in the Rothean topcar formation from Kazakhstan. All these occurrences support the designation of an uppermost Katian age for these levels. Well, summing up, the sampling of the upper part of the Porto Santana formation has provided more than 13 taxa of brachiopods, more than 6 trilobites, more than 9 echinoderms, alga, and bryozoans. Some of these taxa represent the first citation of this taxa in Portugal. The fossil association shows a strong affinity with the cystoid limestone for the Iberian chains, but also with the Rosan formation, Gabion formation, and the Portichedo formation from Sardinia. And finally, few taxa allowed us to date more precisely the age of the uppermost part of the Porto Santana formation as uppermost Cadian, probably a KA for stage slice. That's all. Thank you very much for your attention.